Hello and welcome back to my favourite pastime, everyone. I hope everyone's as excited as I am. Today we'll be looking at Abbotsleigh, but before we get into that, I'd just like to reflect on my previous episode on Kings in my newly renamed segment, Kyle's in the comments. It's the King School, not college. Get your facts right before you display this rubbish. Now, I'll be honest, I did screw up the title, but this is a video where the underlying theme is that your principal is killing underperforming children. And your problem's with the title. Oh well, guess you can't dispute the truth. Do you think you're funny, champ? I love it. I spent 10 minutes bashing them for being too posh, and his response is to call me champ. To be honest, it could have gotten worse. He could have called me sport. Anyway, the best response I've ever received is this clip.
He said, "Headmaster, you should have a look at this." And so, Mr. Edwards and I tell you, I actually found it rather humorous. I learned a lot about our school that I haven't had a chance to have a look at. I thought, you know, Twinkle Toes Tom has done a lot of research on our school, and I'm humbled by that.
Yeah, you see that? I humbled him. So I just want to say big shout out to Tony George, who's one, an absolute legend for not giving people detentions for liking my videos. Yeah, I'm looking at you, Ravo and PLC. And second is now the inaugural winner of the Friend of the Channel Award. Congratulations, sir, congratulations. This prestigious award comes framed and with $5 sticky taped on the back. Also, considering I've been stealing my mother's living room for so long, go check out her art. That's Clifford Draws on Instagram. Wow, is this what it feels like to be nice? Let's get back into bullying then. Anyway, Abbotsleigh, you've waited long enough. Let's start making fun of you. Let's start with your website, shall we? First thing I noticed was the giving button, which when you click it, lets you know of all the incredible ways you can give Abbotsleigh money. You know, I like what they've done with this page. You know, every second sentence has the term tax deductible in it. Anyway, you can give to the foundation or you can give annually, but my favorite thing was gifts in will. Leaving a gift in your will to Abbotsleigh is a very personal decision, but is one that will make an enduring impact on the next generation. How bad of a son or daughter do you have to be that your mother writes a bit of your will out to her high school?
School fees alone do not provide the capital needed to shape the future of Abbotsleigh.
Oh, don't they now? Here's how much it costs to go to Abbotsleigh, by the way. Which, if they go through all of K-12, is a whopping $367,210 per child. Now, let's say Abbotsleigh has about 1,000 students, divide that by 13 years, and then carry the four, and that means Abbotsleigh earns $28,246,923.08. How could you need more money? What are you saving up for the Abbotsleigh space station? Anyway, I was looking for some more videos than just on their YouTube channel, and I came across something called Abnet. Turns out you need a password to enter, but I can't help thinking there's something familiar about that website. Anyway, I guess we'll have to stick with the YouTube videos then. Now, Abbotsleigh has a tradition on their YouTube channel where they, you ever watch Bark Baker? You know, the guy who used to do, like, YouTube parodies of, like, famous songs? Well, Abbotsleigh thought they'd have a crack at that too. Kind of terrifying. There's just children that just come out of bushes. It's like the Gestapo of Abbotsleigh. Yeah, barely noticed the difference there, lads. Seamless, seamless transition. Alright, you're not living it up in the city, alright? You're filming in front of the petrol station. Is it just me or is there something kind of weird about the male teachers going, too hot? Oh yes, the underage women at this school, too hot, yes. God, don't clip that, please. I don't want to critique the song too much, but it's quite clear that that hat isn't stopping the sun, isn't it? Too hot, yes. Wait, wearing your uniform correctly makes you want to praise Jesus. Since when was that a correlation? Oh, I'm wearing my uniform, I believe in Jesus. Prefects are gonna slip it to you. I'm assuming a slip is like a detention thing, right? Why are you bragging about being a snitch? I'm sorry, but like, why? Who would voluntarily get to school early so they can snitch on their mates? I'm sure they're lovely people, but I'm sure that also everyone hates you. Don't believe it, just watch. Guys, I was joking about the Gestapo before. No, they've actually killed her. Oh no, the Gestapo's got Jessica! Run! Run!
Wait a minute. Tie up your hair, put a ribbon in it, take a sec.
This looks like a top 10 thumbnail. What is this? Man, this is so different to my school. You can pierce whatever you want, shave your head, dye your pubes, they won't care.
The flip, right to Sydney, Australia, Wurunga, Abbotsleigh.
Oh no, they've started mowing down children.
Where's the hat?
Don't cross, girl, look out for that van.
Hey, why is she in trouble? She's not the one who pushed her mate down the corridor.
Don't say,
Sorry, safety makes you want to praise the Lord, does it? Oh, jeez, this place is so spick and span. Makes me want to have a bit of a prayer.
Don't cross that highway. Don't cross that highway.
They're getting away! Stop looking at us doing this and go get him! You know what would really make them listen? If they extended that clip and it just ended with...
Don't cross that highway.
Cause
bring back goggles to the
deer. Why do you have to go all Big Brother on her? She didn't even jaywalk. I'm loving this editing technique of just going, well, we didn't film enough, so let's just play the same clip but in reverse.
Before I played sport, I was the little shy kid who sat in the corner and did nothing.
I have a lot of energy and, yeah, I needed to just let it go somewhere.
Does anyone else think that sounds a little threatening?
I had a lot of feelings and pent-up energy. So the school decided to give me a bat.
We have 30 netball teams and 15 hockey teams.
Well, they should be easy to beat because we've tied them up.
And yet the top few items that they thought we needed to improve on were a hockey field, car parking.
Your number two concern about your child's school is car parking. Guys, you need some parking. Let's just knock down the science block.
About 500 girls out of 900 in senior school be playing a Saturday sport, and that's just amazing, and that's really, really great to see, but at the moment we just can't cater for that at school, which is why we need these new facilities.
Or you could just take a bus to a field, you know, like the rest of us have to.
The need is so great that we have pushed forward, and with the support of our parents, we are pleased that we have been able to do.
Okay, maybe before you guys just have to build more fields, why don't you teach them to not go after their own teammate first?
With all these new facilities coming, I think everyone will try more sports.
I don't think that's how things work. No one goes, oh, well, they've built a new stripper pole, I have to have a go now.
There's new gyms, courts, field outside.
This is really sad. She was listing off all those cool things, and I was more impressed that her soccer goal had a net in it. We're still working on the posts.
Our dance program, for instance, has, I think, 600 plus girls in it.
If you've got 600 dance students, why don't, I don't know, cull some of them. Let's be real, 400 of them probably suck. So how about when you need to go dancing, you just take that 400, drop them off at Hornsby Westfield and tell them to have fun for a few hours.
One of the things that we're really happy to deliver, and that is car parking.
Guys, how do you earn 28 million a year and don't have the budget to put weights on the bars? Come on, lads. Yes! Finally! It's back! Wait, what happened to, like, the electronic counting system? Hey, you can't do budget fencing. The next video I have saved is Justice Crew performs at Abbotsleigh School for Girls. How did you bloody get Justice Crew? Look, Abbotsleigh, all I'm saying, I can do that.
Yeah, wow, Justice Crew, real big name.
I'm sorry, have you heard of a little something called Public School Anthem? Seriously, Justice Crew? This is your dance move? Really? I've seen TikToks more creative. Five, six, seven, eight.
I can't say, like, one thing. There's so many things that I love about Abbotsleigh.
Guys, come on. That's the textbook thing you say when you've got nothing to say.
It's like you're in a massive family.
Oh my God, where's the hats? How are they going to praise the Lord?
I think other people are doing their best, so that makes you want to as well.
That sounds like a really roundabout way of saying that other people are doing your work for you. Yeah, look, other people are working so hard, I just thought I'd give them my work too. Just, they're on fire.
There's not really one definition of an Abbotsleigh girl.
You can't define an Abbotsleigh girl. All right, here's mine. A girl that goes to Abbotsleigh. There you go.
We have amazing teachers. There's
so supportive. They'll meet you anytime, after school, before school, lunchtime. They'll bake you food if you have before school classes.
Your teachers bake food?
Why doesn't my school like me?
It's probably because I publicly insulted them that one time. But other than that...
My favourite facility is the school library.
Wow, yes, that would be my favourite as well. Just glass everywhere. That's impressive. Do you guys know that walls exist, or...?
There's little study nooks and, like, big areas.
Oh, a study nook. You know, like a little enclosed area. Oh, that's lovely. Well, for the people who don't build every wall out of glass, we just call them rooms.
You feel, like, a sense of, like, belonging. You belong here, you know? You're not meant to be anywhere else.
You belong here. As long as you've got money. We may be tax deductible, but we sure as hell ain't no charity.
Good morning and welcome to the 2017 Abbotsleigh Speech Day. Please stand for the official party and remain standing for our acknowledgement of country and the national anthem. I would now like to invite our Archbishop, the Most Reverend Dr. Glenn Davies, to welcome us here today.
Can I sit down yet or what?
Thank you, Chairman of School Council and Headmistress.
It just feels awkward that we're both standing, Glenn. Like, can I sit down yet?
Members of Council, members of staff, parents, grandparents, siblings in compulsory attendance, and...
That's a good one, Glenn.
Girls.
Good morning.
What? Who cut him off? That was a great joke.
And on behalf of Council...
Bring Glenn back. Bring Glenn back.
The one thing that never changes is, of course, change.
What do you mean change doesn't change? It does. The amount of change can change. So, change does change. What are you on about?
What amazing girls you are.
Oh, we're standing up again. Far out.
Now, Speech Day is always a day of celebration.
Honestly, it sounds like a day of pain. So essentially, it's just anyone who wants to have a chat for about half an hour gets to go up on Speech Day and then just give an award at the end. Fun. Right, so as I was looking through the ways you can give Abbotsleigh cash on their website, one thing stood out to me. Each year, many generous members of our school community encourage excellence by endowing a Speech Day prize. A gift of $5,000 to the foundation will endow a prize in perpetuity, aka forever, with the option to name the prize. Now, this is a massive shout out to any one of my fans that has $5,000 or more of disposable income. I really want to endow a prize. And I don't want my prize to be like for a good thing. I want it to be like the Twinkle Toe Tom Award for biggest dropkick. It'd be like if Sportsbet ranked all the odds for people who are going to drop out of your year, and the person most likely wins the Twinkle Toe Tom Biggest Dropkick Award. You know, I'd want it to be like a stain on people's resume. Like, oh, you got a 95 on your ATAR, but you're also the Twinkle Toe Tom Biggest Dropkick Award winner? Come on, Abbotsleigh. You get $5,000, I get to laugh. And I get to make a speech on Speech Day. Oh, it's a win-win. So, if you have any disposable income, please give it to me. That's official Twinkle Toe Tom on Instagram. Anyway, that's all from me. Like and subscribe. Do all the other things. Oh, tell me who I should do next. Yeah, yada, yada, yada. Yeah, all that. And Tony, I'll get that award to you. One day, eventually.